And before I start, I just want to dedicate this poem to Rylee Sears. Anyway, hope that you guys enjoy this performance. And at the end, if you like it, let me know, okay? So I'm gonna get the show underway. One of the most dangerous places a person could ever live in is the comfort zone. Unfortunately, this place is all too well known, for its inhabitants go well over 7 numerical digits, and me bringing this up is already making some fidget, but that's okay, because I was hoping I would bring a little bit of discomfort. Now the comfort zone, this area of low risk and safety, has us going about our lifestyles relatively safely. And the ones who step outside of the comfort zone just get labeled as crazy. And while they pursue their dreams bravely, we sit around safely, repeating words like one day, what if, and maybe. But lately, I've been feeling pretty uncomfortable with my surroundings. I want to break out of this box. There's far too many people inside, and to be honest, it's getting kind of claustrophobic. The truth is, I've just got to change my focus and stop living such a low-risk life. I'm stepping into the discomfort zone, and honestly, my hope is that some of you would join me. Because the truth is, nobody ever remembers the folks who live their entire lives stuck inside the comfort zone. I mean, all you've got to do is read some history. Like, just listen for a moment and you'll see what I mean. Like, do we really think life was comfortable for Dr. King with the movement that he led and the conflict it would bring? Constant death threats and danger, all leaving such a sting. Arrested and put in jail, comfort was definitely not a sting. And speaking of jail, what about Nelson Mandela? In prison for 27 years, that was an uncomfortable fella. Yeah, the road to anti-apartheid probably brought him a lot of hurt. But thanks to his efforts, he's received international applause. He's changed South Africa forever because of his work. But why don't we bring something a little bit closer to home and talk about somebody we could probably relate to a bit better, like, say, Sidney Crosby, one of the world's greatest athletes ever to play the game of hockey. Spending countless hours at the gym, early mornings at the rink, putting so much hard work in, and do we really think that he had no moments of discomfort? Working day in and day out most likely brought that dude some hurt. But you see, he pushed past the pain because he saw what could be gained, and now Sidney Crosby is a household name. But whoa, 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 hold up. We need to understand that it ain't about fame, but rather consistently striving for growth so that we don't remain the same. But the truth be told, when you live in the discomfort zone, it's impossible for people not to take notice. I mean, look at Gandhi and Mother Teresa, perfect examples of how I know this. And I can name person after person, but regardless, my hope is that these spoken words would inspire a change of focus. But you know what I've noticed is that there seems to be a lot of people that have gotten so comfortable they've actually fallen asleep. But thankfully, I'm here with a microphone, ready to scream. Wake up! Wake up! I know you got some dreams being asleep in your normality, but I'm here to say, hey, go make those dreams a reality. It's time to get up off that comfortable couch of mediocrity and start living your life as the person that you ought to be. Because honestly, we've got to see the reality that's staring us all dead in the eyes, which is that one day we will eventually die. And that is exactly why I'm speaking to you with such urgency. Like, it's a thought that rarely crosses our minds. But yet tonight, we've reached an intersection. And even as I spit these lines, you can choose your direction, but beware, because the clock is ticking. We got a limited amount of years. I mean, all you gotta do is ask my boy, Rylee Sears. Like, this time last month, he was still here, and the fact that he's gone now has brought so many tears, and it still feels so unreal. And as life continues on, I don't even know how I'm supposed to feel. But regardless of that, I do know that RS-17 will live forever in our hearts. And thanks to that young man, I'm living the rest of my life completely set apart from the comfort zone. Because in the comfort zone, It's like you're just merely existing. Yet in the discomfort zone, that's where you'll truly be living. Cause the truth is, we got plenty people who died with potential who are lying in our cemeteries. But you see, that's the thing that I actually find most scary. Cause see, I'm not so much scared of death, but rather going to my grave with potential left. I said I'm not so much scared of death, but rather going to my grave with potential left. And when the moment comes that I take my last breath, I pray that I would have zero potential left. And that's why every single day I'm doing my absolute best to live within the discomfort zone. My goal is nothing less. And at my funeral, they can say that I died with emptiness. And they can say that every dream and every goal, every single passion and every single hope that I possessed were things that I actually went on to accomplish. And they can say that my purpose that God gave to me was something that I chose to pursue relentlessly. And they can say that the discomfort zone was my place of residence, and that in everything I did, it was done with such excellence. So this is me, Spencer Conway, formally inviting all of you to join me in the discomfort zone. No need to be hesitant. Your excuses are irrelevant. It's one of the best decisions you could ever make, and I've made that pretty evident. It's time for all of us to come together and start pursuing discomfort over comfort 24/7. Because the truth is, none of us know how many seconds we've got left. Carpe diem, seize the day before you're seized by death.